Penguin Random House Audio presents Pieces of Happiness, a novel of friendship, hope, and chocolate by Anne Ostby. Translated from the Norwegian by Marie Ostby. Read for you by Jilly Bond.
We should not be defined by the smallness of our islands, but by the greatness of our oceans. Epeli Hawofa. There are so many islands, as many islands as the stars at night on that branched tree from which meteors are shaken like falling fruit around the schooner flight. But things must fall, and so it always was. On one hand Venus, on the other Mars. Fall and are one, just as this Earth is one island in archipelagos of stars. Derek Walcott. Prologue. An invitation and a challenge. Korototoka, Fiji, 25th of July, 2012. My dear friend, can I still call you that? The stamps on the letter made you curious, I'm sure, but you've probably already realised who it is. Stamps with pictures of iguanas and parrotfish could only come from Cat. A voice from a time long ago. A fellowship we once had. Do you think we could ever find it again? Thank you for the hugs and the kind words when I needed them the most. I know it wasn't possible to drop everything and travel across the world for the funeral. From where you are, it must be hard to imagine someone being sung into eternity with a four-part Fijian harmony, while the mourners come carrying woven mats of all things. How many straw mats does a departed one need, you might ask? And I would have to answer, as Atetha explained to me, as many as it takes to honour Mr. Niklas's life. So I've spread the mats out across the porch. Dried palm fronds in a checkered pattern, an anchor for the body, and a firm foundation for the thoughts, which often plunge into the fiery sunsets alongside the bats here in Korototoka. At night the longing comes, the sharp and aching longing for Niklas and the life we lived before. A marathon of global misery, you might say. A long-distance race with a global pandemic or an environmental crisis at every water station. Yes, that too. But I wouldn't change a thing. The bouts of malaria, the lack of water, the nights of itching flea bites, they taught me to make do. Whether it's making do without money, toilet paper, shampoo, or a blue-chip pension. And so here I am, sitting on a tiny speck in the middle of the Pacific Ocean, mateless, but not helpless. And not friendless, I hope. I have 22 acres of cocoa trees and a house with plenty of room. I have a body full of minor aches and pains, but I've planted my feet on Fijian earth, and I intend to stay here until the last sunset. Why don't you join me? Leave behind everything that didn't work out. Bring with you everything that still matters, and move into a room in Vale ne Cat, Cat's house. This can be the place where we find each other again. And if there's nothing to find, we'll create something new. I haven't been the best at keeping in touch. I know there weren't many updates from me from Nepal, Afghanistan, or Mauritius. But I've missed you. I've missed everyone in our old gang. I've read your letters and emails, admired your pictures of children and grandchildren. And now I wonder, would it be possible to bring us together again? After a gap of over 40 years, do you want to join me and walk the last leg together? To try to help each other if one of us trips and the other one limps? To dip our aching knees in the warm, salty waves and bury our toes in white sand? I'm not looking for free labour. The plantation is in good hands. Korototoka is a cocoa village, and Mosese, the manager, takes care of harvesting, fermenting and drying the beans. But maybe we could start something new here, take a chance together. Perhaps make chocolate, or a delicious-smelling cocoa body lotion. What do you think? I'm sure you understand why I couldn't send this via email. A letter can take days and weeks on its journey from one world to another, and the words find the right depth and gravity along the way. As they fall into your hands right now, they've had time to mature and soften and be cradled by the paper's curve, ready to entice you here. Can you taste the flavour of papaya and coconut? Can you hear the wind whistling through the palm trees on the beach? Can you see the arc of the horizon, where the Pacific Ocean meets the sky? Of course, if the ice scraper, the engine heater and the electricity bill are more tempting, please put this in a drawer, never to be opened again. A letter can easily disappear on its way across the seas, and the postal service from the Pacific is more unreliable than a tropical cyclone or a Fijian ministry post. In which case, you never received it, and no questions will be asked. So I'm going to send this now, stroking my fingers across the stamps for luck, hoping the wind will send you to me. Maybe Vale Nekat can be a home for all of us, a women's house where we can dream, hope, drink, laugh, fight, and cry together, until the wind sweeps us out over the waves, and it's our mats that are carried up the stairs and spread wide across the porch. Lolo Mas, Cat. Chapter 1. Sina.
I'm broke. I'm so sorry.
They haven't seen each other in decades, and the first thing Sina finds herself blurting out to Cat is the depressing state of her finances, for goodness sake. She bites down on her lip hard, fighting the quiver, and opens her arms to the tall, smiling woman with the sunglasses on her head.
Oh, Cat, it's so good to see you. You look amazing.
In the arrivals hall at Nandi Airport, strumming a cheerful welcome melody, a ukulele band greets the shorts-clad tourists. The singer, in a brightly patterned shirt and a flower tucked behind his ear, winks at Sina, who quickly shuffles closer to Cat.
Mbula!
Sina's worried frown gets lost in her friend's welcome hug.
Mbula, Vinaka! You're here now, that's what matters. One thing at a time, it will all work out. Let me look at you.
Cat pushes Sina away, flashing her a big, sparkling smile. And it's just like old times. She pulls her close again for another hug.
I can't believe you're actually here.
Me neither.
Sina chokes back a few tears. She's trembling with exhaustion after a journey that took her nearly 48 hours, and another loud opening chord from the ukulele trio startles her. A pair of wide hips draped in an orange floral pattern comes swaying towards her.
Umbula, madam. Welcome to Fiji.
The woman, smile aglow with 100 luminous white teeth, places a flower garland around Sina's neck. Sina grips her luggage trolley tightly and stumbles after Cat as she heads out into the dark, hot, humid October night. Korototoka is a 2-hour drive away. The darkness is thicker than it is back home. As soon as they put the bright lights of the airport behind them, it's like being in a tunnel without walls. So close and yet so open, it makes Sina dizzy. Look at the stars, Cat encourages her, and Sina glances up and out of the open window. The night sky is a maze of shining dots, a frozen explosion of fireworks. Her head tips back. She has to pull her gaze back into the car. Cat looks at her and smiles. Pretty amazing, huh? Suddenly she slams on the brakes. Sina lurches forward and the seatbelt catches her. She gets a glimpse of a scrawny horse careering towards the side of the road. Cat shakes her head and drives on, a little slower now.
It can be dangerous driving through the villages at night. The animals roam free. You never know when a cow will just appear in the middle of the road.
The ocean on one side, trees on the other, sand dunes. Fields with plants she doesn't recognise. Sugar cane, Cat nods. Sugar and corn are the two most important crops here. The darkness is occasionally punctuated by clusters of houses. A light bulb flickers here and there. Sina squints to make out the shapes of the buildings. sees that some of those alongside the road are just small sheds made of corrugated metal. Is this how they're going to live? She's the first to arrive in Fiji. Ingrid and Lisbeth will be arriving over the next few weeks. And eventually Maya, too. Apparently there were some health problems she had to discuss with her doctor first. An unsettled feeling surges.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.